Okay, cool beans. So, picking up from Wednesday, as you can see, the market gave us the general move that we were looking for. Give me a second. Let me take this RSI off of there. I do use the RSI sometimes to see when price is oversold and overbought, but that's all I use it for. I don't use it to base no analysis off of. So don't do that. Okay, so cool. So we can see that the market gave us the general move that we were looking for. I told you guys Monday that I wanted to see, not Monday, Wednesday, I wanted to see the dollar come back down and retest its level and keep pushing, or that it could possibly just go ahead and take off. And as we can see, it went ahead and took off. I told you guys Monday to start that week out that I wanted to see the dollar be bullish and I wanted to see it hold above 93.6, 93.4, this level here. As we can see, price came back, retested that level perfectly and took off. That was Monday. We got that move. Wednesday, I told you guys I wanted to see it retest these levels, keep pushing. We didn't get the retest, it just kept pushing, which is still a good thing. My only concern is that the market goes in the general direction that I want it to go. So, based off of those things right there, we already know how we were looking to play the currency pairs that we trade. Being that the currency pairs that we trade, they move in the opposite direction of the dollar. We already know if we're expecting the dollar to be bullish, then we're expecting our currency pairs to be bearish. So as we can see, same thing, exact opposite of the dollar. I wanted to see the dollar come up and retest here and then sell, but as you can see, the dollar just went ahead and sold. You did get a chance to get in on a entry here for
I
yourself
fell.
on the retest, and that was a beautiful sale. So boom, everything was
Got one
great.
plate.
That was beautiful for Euro USD. Give me one second. Okay, cool. That was a beautiful trade for Euro USD. Moving on to GBP USD. So you guys Wednesday that you could either sell from here, put your stop loss above here. If you took that entry, you would have got stopped out. But a smart trader would have been able to discern the fact that this was also an entry level here as well. So you should have very well took this entry, especially if you didn't take this one, you should have damn sure took this one. So as we can see, price came up, hit this entry level here and kept selling. And as a matter of fact, this was the original entry. This right here was added on. That came from me trying to be perfect. But you see what doing too much gets you. It could get you a loss. So stick with your original analysis and the market ends up playing out perfectly for you. So good trade, GBP USD, beautiful. NZD USD, we got the retest today. I wanted to see it come up between, I told you guys Wednesday night, I wanted to see it come up and test and sell, but I didn't think it was going to take all the way up to the day to get the retest. But that just goes to show you that I don't make the market do nothing. The market do what it want to do. My new motto that I just came up with is we don't predict the market, we roll with the market. So that's never my job, never trying to predict the market. I'm just trying to roll with the market. So we got the entry here today. Patience is a virtue. Patience is a virtue. Patience is a virtue. One of the most important things to mastering trading is patience. Patience is a virtue. So you see that we got the entry today and perfect. If you held to the close, 56. If you rent it down to its max, it was 71 pips. That was beautiful. EZBUSD, beautiful. Moving on to Bitcoin. Hold on, give me a second. Okay. Moving on to Bitcoin. I tell you guys Wednesday. So I told you guys Wednesday that if Bitcoin, yeah, I told you guys Wednesday, I just wanted to make sure that I was in the right area. So yeah, told you guys that if Bitcoin broke above here, wait for the retest, get in for the buy. Bitcoin never gave you a good, like this, I don't consider this a good break. What do we consider a good break? A strong aggressive candle, right? Do you see a strong aggressive candle anywhere up in here? Nope. So I wouldn't have got in right here. I would have still been patient. Patience is a virtue. Patience is a virtue. Patience is a virtue. I would have been patient, waiting for price to show me what it was gonna do. I wouldn't have got into over here. Because I start seeing what? Strong, aggressive candles. As one of my early educators used to say, Max used to say, a convincing candle. Because it convinces you that the market is ready to make the move that you're looking for. So you want to see those convincing candles, those aggressive candles. And then once you see it break up like that, and then you see that aggressive candle like that, and you see it come back down to give you that retest. Don't break back below this low. You take the trade, put your stop loss below the previous low, and you take the trade. It's calculated risk. It's not a gamble, it's a calculated risk, because you have made all of the calculations and all of the probabilities. You have everything in your favor according to the knowledge that you hold and according to the analysis that you've done. You have the probability of the trade going in your favor because you've taken the time to assess all of these things. So now, only thing you gotta do is press the button. That's like one of the hardest things it is for people that's new to trading to do, is to trust themselves and to trust their analysis. I still struggle with it too, and I'm 4 years in. That's one of the hardest things, practicing patience, practicing patience and pressing the button. You gotta press the button. I'm telling you, you ain't gonna never make no money if you don't press the button. You just gonna be looking at the chart saying, dang, he said it was going in that direction. He said, and you just gonna be looking at everybody else post their profits. And at the same time, you're gonna be dying on the inside as far as a trader. You're gonna be dying as a trader. And your will to learn how to trade is going to be dying because you're doing yourself the disservice of not pressing the button and not trusting your analysis. So you got to press the button. You got to press the button. So Bitcoin, beautiful. Moving on to silver. Wanted to see silver give us this sell. We got the sell. And then, of course, if silver break back above the levels, you want to see a good aggressive break, retest, and you take the buy. I'm going to talk about what I want for silver moving forward after I go over there. Didn't get the move out of gold. Wanted to see gold come back up here and retest this level. It came up, but it didn't. Trade wouldn't have got true. Make a long story short. So that trade didn't get true. No worries, no harm, no foul. Last but not least, my baby, U30. Told you guys in the beginning of the week, I wanted to see U30 come up, retest this level right here. This was our sale in the beginning of the week. Beautiful sale. I told you guys if it broke below here, gave us a retest, then we could get in for the sale. But you see on this break, it didn't give us a retest. What did it do? Shot straight back up through it and came back up, tried to retest these price levels again, but didn't have enough buying power behind it. And what did you see? Another sell off. So a trader who knows what he's doing, he would have definitely got back in, not right here, but here or here. Once he's seen that price couldn't break this high, break above there, and give us that move that we was looking for to the upside, he would have definitely got back in right here, like I did, and ride it down. Because price obviously showing that it can't get back above this high and it can't break this price level right here, these price levels right here. So we've seen the market break back down, seen price break back down. We've seen price come back up, give us this retail. This is the trade I sent out in the group this morning because I seen price couldn't get back above this high. And it was giving me the retest of the bottom of this zone right here. I don't know why my other indices. All right, cool. So seeing it coming back up, seeing it couldn't get back above. So this right here is when I see the sale alert out in the Telegram group. And as you can see, damn near no pullback. No pullback. And slam down for 2,500 pips. Yep, you heard me correct. 2,500 pips. At the smallest lot size, that was $250. At the smallest you can go, that was $250. And then we see the close, the market tried to rally up at the close, but it didn't break back above this high. So now, to look in, to look forward, moving forward. Let me tell you. Well, you go to the daily. Everything God. Okay. So what I want to see, let me see. So what I want to see, okay. The dollar probably gonna be bearish to start the week off with last week, because if you see these, all these, like this was Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday. This was a bullish week. And now we see today was bearish day. I think to start next week out, we're going to start out being bearish, and then we'll end the week bullish. Kind of something similar. If the dollar continue its bullish run, it'll be kind of something similar to what happened this week. So with that being said, we already know how we are looking to play the currencies. We know how we're looking to play the metals and the indices. So with that being said, I'll bring the recording to an end, and then I'll take any questions anybody may have.